As a gamer, one of the greatest things, short of your chosen title actually getting an update, is the announcement of one and what the update should contain. I think this is especially true in sim racing, because the vast majority of us use wheels and pedals, and that changes what can be felt in the most literal sense. So with Automobilista 2 recently announcing not one, but two updates, because they've so much stuff to give us and change, I got a bit excited. In this video, I'm going to give you the shorter version of what we've got coming. A link to the original post from Rita is in the description. But we've got cars, tracks, physics, and multiplayer news. Some of this stuff is already out there, but I'm going to cover everything in the post just to make sure you don't miss anything. The Stock Car Pro Series has gotten an update, which now includes the 2023 roster. It's noted that the cars themselves remain largely unchanged, but they will feature the new Hankook tyres, but these won't appear in-game until after the tire update, which I'll go into later. Also, recently released was the 1971 version of Nürburgring. Honestly, it's absolutely fantastic, with amazing lighting, campfires, and general atmosphere around the circuit. The core track itself is spectacular. A real triumph. Bravo for this release. This is available now, and it's mentioned that the modern version is getting an update too, but no planned ETA. This is going to address trackside details and enhance mesh resolution. You should check out the video GP laps made on this track. It's so good. I'll leave a link in the description. Now for the first of the upcoming releases. Circuit de Barcelona is coming and expected to arrive in late May. This circuit requires little introduction. It's iconic and used in many different motorsport codes. A fantastic addition to any sim. It's planned as a standalone DLC, and the estimated price point is $6.99 or €5.99. It's worth noting that this will be added to the 2022 season pass holders for no additional charge. I really liked that Risa pointed out, with the addition of this track, Automobilista 2 contains close to 50% of modern GP tracks over the last 40 years, adding that by the end of 2023, they'll have over 50% of the last 50 years, with similar strike rates of Group C, GT1, IMSA, and GT World Challenge. To me, there can be little argument that the content offering in Automobilista 2 is absolutely incredible. Let me know down in the comments what your favourite content in Automobilista 2 is, or what you'd like to see brought into the sim. The Formula USA 2023 will make a return. The 2022 version that was to be included in the 1.4 update was subject to an objection from IndyCar due to the similarity with their IR18. So Rita went back to the drawing board and created their own 2023 version. It will come with road, short oval, and speedway variants, and will be added to the Racing USA Part 3 and all packages that include it. As part of the update planned for late May, all users will get a new prototype. Type, the Sigma P1 G5, a very cool looking race car. It's always good to add a freebie to the base content. And also, to be added to the base content for free is the Formula Junior. This represents a starter low power vehicle from the 1960s, extremely light at 400 kilograms, skinny tyres, and just over 100 brake horsepower. I'm genuinely excited for this car. I'm absolutely positive it's going to provide some fantastic racing. Please do consider hitting that subscribe button and the like. It really helps the channel so much. The 1.5 update will also bring what seems to be fairly major physics updates. These changes are expected in June sometime, I'd guess towards the end of it. The focus of these changes are on tyres, aero, and suspension. They've discovered that the Setter tyre model, which is used by the Madness engine that Automobilista 2 is based on, was being, as they call it, confused by values it was being fed by the old ISI P motor model. This made a bit of a mess of the tyre carcass simulation. This might seem odd, but the original Automobilista was based on R Factor from ISI. I guess somewhere there's an overlap of code when they moved engine, and this is another step of phasing out that legacy code. A good move nonetheless. Correcting this issue led them to revise how suspension and aero works within the sim too. So all in all, it should be quite a major upgrade. For me personally, I absolutely love how Automobilista 2 handles with the lower speed vehicles especially things like the Caterham, but I have felt for some time that high downforce, high speed cars feel a bit odd in their handling. I won't pretend that I'm an expert in vehicle dynamics, but I do hope these changes alter things towards what I would expect. I'm also super excited that they've said they're going to be multiplayer enhancements with substantial updates, including netcode developments. That'll help with Racecraft Online, a new awesome service which makes it super easy to race online. A link should be appearing in the top corner of the video now for you to go and check out how to get involved. But what do you think to these additions and changes to the sim? Are you happy with the direction it's taking? Is there something you'd like them to work on? Let me know in the comments down below. And as always, thank you for watching.